How are you?
Very good. Ma'am, shall I start?
Please start.
You start. I told you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Namaskaram. A very warm welcome to one and all present here. I, Gaurika Jindal of Class 12 from Delhi Public School, Yamunanagar, is going to moderate this entire program today. I am accompanied by my co-host, Arshia Goyal of Class 12, for the smooth functioning of this entire program. We take privilege and honor in welcoming you all to this great Master Series program under the patronage of Spic Mekin. The whole world had been indulged by the contagion known as COVID-19. During this pandemic, many precious lives of our great artists have been snuffed out of their air. Let's pay a sincere homage to all these departed souls. So, I would request everyone to have 1 minute of silence in the memory of those who left a deep void in the Indian culture and music with their untimely demise.
Gorika.
Now, I would request Arshia to throw some light on the history of Spic Mekin.
Thank you, Gaurika. Namaskaram. Spic Mekin, founded by Padam Shri Professor Kiran Seth, is a highly celebrated organization that has launched a new renaissance for the revival of Indian culture and art among the youth. They hold a prolific record of holding more than 5,000 programs per year, covering the entire length and breadth of this country. All these programs are organized by thousands of volunteers, largely students, teachers, housewives, retired people, professionals, young and old. Spic Mekin celebrates Nisham Sena, the spirit of volunteerism, of giving selflessly without expectation. We all are blessed to have among us eminent Odissi dancer, Srimati Aruna Mohanty ji, who is the disciple of Padam Shri awardee, legendary guru, the main exponent of Odissi dance, highly revered and hallowed soul, Sri Gangadhar Pradhan ji. A very hearty welcome to all of you for Great Master Series program. Now, I would request our Honorable Principal Sir, Mr. B. Murli, to honor our guest for today.
Far on it.
Video.
Yes.
Good afternoon. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, you can put your video on.
It's not getting.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Yes.
Good afternoon. Today, DPS Yamunanagar is blessed to organize, to interact with the eminent Odissi dancer and to know about Guruji Gangadhar Pradhan. And his disciple will be discussing about his life and likes and how he motivated the disciples also in the field of Odissi. And I welcome the guest and other audience to join us in the motive of keeping and uplifting our culture and heritage to the younger generations. That is the motive of the P.S. Yamunanagar as well as the Spik Mekke. Spik Mekke is doing a wonderful job, a non-profit organization working for the benefit of the artist and bringing their work and arranging, organizing numerous programs all over the world and spreading Indian culture heritage to the world. And especially for the Indian students, it is a good platform to learn directly from the gurus. With their blessings, they will be learning more and more of different talents. It's not only the dance, music, cinema. They take care of the art culture also, which the child may not be knowing that which place they are have. That also they are bringing into the limelight of the children. And it's a good platform for my children and others also to learn new things, even in this pandemic time too. I am thankful and in depth to Spik Mekke, Mr. Seth, Dr. Seth, for giving us this opportunity to host this such programs. Even in future also, we have planned for the And About Three and other week programs also. We will be participating, and I expect my children and neighboring schools also will join in the way of propagating or taking our culture into nook and corner, every children. Thanks once again for the Spik Mekke for giving us the opportunity to host the program. And I welcome the guests to this program to enrich the children with the Odissi dance. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Your words are like the sparkle that ignites the passion towards the revival Indian culture, art and dance form. Now, I would like to call upon Gaurika to introduce the illuminary and the most towering figure of the current century, Guru Gangadhar Pradhanji.
Thank you, Arshia. To a novice soul like me, it is a Herculean task to introduce this intonating star of Odissi dance, Guru Gangadhar Pradhanji. Like a tenderloin orb, he spread his illumination in the entire cosmos. Sometimes even a single turn of a dance brings out the raw and real talent. The fundamental aim of dance is to evoke a response in the rasika. The rapport can be achieved easily by simple but beautiful formation of dance. Guru Gangadhar Pradhanji was born on 10th July 1948 to Muralidhar Pradhanji and Dwitika Deviji. An interesting incident happened during the infant stage of Guruji's life when he fell down from a bullock cart and was injured severely. After the Guruji's recovery, his father vowed to send him to the iconic Shiva temple at Balunkeshwar to serve there for 10 years as a devotee. Guruji was a boy of prodigious and precocious talent right from his early age. He was not only outrageously beautiful, but he quickly grasped the key components of Odissi dance. In 1966, he entered Utkal Sangeet Mahavidyalaya. He won first prize at All Odisha Dance Competition held at Puri. Apart from choreography, composing dance, dramas, and ballets, he composed in the genre of regional folk dance. The Academy has performed for national and international audiences. His contribution in making Odissi dance a regular phenomena in Odisha and all over India is unparalleled and unrivaled. He established Konark Natya Mandap in 1986. He also established Chandrasekhar Kala Mandir in 1992. For his efforts, he was awarded State Sangeet Natak Academy Award by the President of India. He trained under some of the most renowned gurus of his time, like Mahaguru Chandrasekhar Patnaik, Mahaguru Pankaj Chandra Das, and Mahaguru Banali Maharona. He was a prolific performer and performed all over the world. He was awarded Padma Shri by the Government of India in 2008 and also a doctorate degree from Utkal University in 2010. Guru Gangadhar Pradhanji, in his illustrious career, holds many prominent positions, like he was the president of Rotary Club Konark and president of Utkala Atma. Such a celestial and divine soul has graced this earth with his birth and attained the highest form of salvation by immersing himself in the souls of his disciples. Now, I would like to call upon Arshia to introduce our honorable guest who has dazzled the entire cosmos with her breathtaking Odissi dance performances, Guru Vidushi Aruna Mohanty ji. Over to Arshia.
Thank you, Gaurika. A small couplet to describe the colossal status of Vidushi Aruna Mohanty ji. You rose to the sky with such a sheer pride. Your expressions and visions are the representation of your seasons. Under the aegis of renowned guru, you bloomed with such confidence and flew to the pinnacle of success. Vidushi Aruna Mohanty ji belongs to an era where the true essence of guru, where the true essence of Guru Shishya Parampara was celebrated in its most pious form. She, like a true disciple, followed the holy sermons of his master and got ordained in the classical and influential dance form of Odisha known as Odissi dance. For her sincere, sustained, unwavering efforts, she was awarded Padma Shri by the Government of India in the year 2016. She trained vigorously under the patronage of her towering guru, Sri Gangadhar Pradhanji. The entire career is filled with the glories of dance form. She is also a visiting scholar at the prestigious universities in America. She has uniquely and deftly used her art to portray contemporary and mythological stories depicting the different shades of Indian women, such as Sita, Draupadi, Mandodari, and Nirbhaya. She is proudly carrying forward the legacy of making Odissi dance reaching heart and soul of common India. Your illuminating presence has created the sanguine and divine aura. Now, I would hand over the conference to Gaurika. Let's start the interaction session.
Thank you, Arshia. I can see many enthusiastic faces from Delhi Public School, Yamunanagar, who are eager to ask questions. So, with your permission, ma'am, I would like to begin with the interactive session. I would request Anisha to begin. Over to Anisha.
Namaskaram to Guru Vidushi Aruna Mohanty ji. My name is Anisha and I'm from 12th standard. It's a great privilege interacting with you. And I want to humbly ask you that why Honorable Guru Gangadhar Pradhanji was the beacon of light for the Odissi dance?
Thank you for having me here. I would like to thank Speak Meke. I would like to thank the Yamunanagar DBS school for giving me this wonderful opportunity to talk to you. First of all, Jai Kala, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Deva, Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat, Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave. Guru Gangadhar Pradhan, for me, is the light, a resplendent aura. He just touched us, all our students. I have been associated with him for last 50 years. If in 2-3 lines I have to describe him, I will say that he loved and he was very passionate about the art form that we see, which which has got the fragrance and the color and the essence of this soil of Odisha. Apart from that, he was a dreamer. He taught us how to think and dream and be in love with the art form as if we are worshipping the art form. We are getting our identity for the entire state, for the entire region, for the country. Because of the art form, I am. The art form is there, therefore we are. He taught us that. And he taught us that how you should be in love and in harmony with each other so the entire Odissi fraternity can live like a big family, other South Kal. He never thought about individual performances, individual glory, individual name, but he used each one of us to create a beautiful niche for Odissi worldwide. And he always stood for quality over quantity. And he stood for all the allied art forms from Odisha, which has enriched over the years in restructuring, recreate Odissi dance in post-independence era. Though Odissi dates back to 2000 years, but Odissi came into its pristine form, restructured, during post-independence era, and he thought all those allied art forms, be it Gotipua, be it Devadasi, be it Tau dance, be it other forms of folk dance forms and tribal forms, he gave equal importance to all these roots and collected information and the technique and the vocabulary and tried to enrich Odissi. So in a way, he was a practitioner, he was a learner of Odissi, then he became a performer Odissi, teacher in Odissi, then he used to play Mardala. So he was a great musician, kind of, taking Odissi Mardala to a greater height. But at the same time, he was a researcher and he provided platforms to young dancers as well as senior professionals. As an artist, he thought, he should provide a platform to the art form and artist.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for enlightening us. Now, I would like to call upon Samarveer Rana. Over to you, Samarveer.
Ji, namaskar, Aruna Mohanty, ma'am. Mera naam Samarveer Rana hai, aur main kakshya 12vi ka chhatra hu. Mera aapse hai ye prashn hai, कि जैसे गुरु गंगाधर जी ने गुरु शिष्य की परंपरा को बहुत ही महत्व दिया और वे उसमें सफल भी रहे, तो क्या ये गुरु शिष्य परंपरा आज के समय में भी व्यापक है? धन्यवाद.
समरवीर, इट इज अ ब्यूटीफुल क्वेश्चन एंड दिस इज एक्चुअली अ ब्यूटीफुल थ्रेड व्हिच हैज काइंड ऑफ कनेक्टेड ऑल ऑफ अस, ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. In that Guru Shishya Parampara, Guruji used to say that when you say Guru, he is not the only one who is teaching us dance, the vocabulary, the grammar, and the poses, and the footwork, and how to emote, and things like that. A Guru is one who guides you how to think, how to appreciate as a human being. How you observe the life around yourself and understand the way of life of a particular place or region or where the art form is growing, you have to understand that. You have to see the rural India, the urban India, you have to see the tribal areas, you have to see the different district with different dialect, the people and their lifestyles, the way they eat, they think, they get married, fall in love, and express their emotions, language, everything you have to observe. So, and he used to tell me, I'll just share you briefly, that when he was teaching me, he will tell me when to get up, how to exercise this and everything, and drink and eat, milk and things like that. Finish your studies. If you are not going to do well in your studies, then poor my parents won't allow me to invest my time in dance. So he said, you have to do that. So he used to take care of my studies also when I have to finish my homework and everything and go to school, come back, play for 1 hour and rest for 1 hour, then again finish your studies at 9:30. He will come to make me practice dance from 9:30 to 11:30. So that was a kind of a, you know, timetable he fixed it, for me. And he said, when you are riding a bicycle, remember, you have to be so careful that you should not fall down, there should not be injury, so that it will affect your dance. So he was thinking of dance, but he was looking at the life, all aspects of your life, that how should you create the balance so that to be a dancer, there will be no hindrances. So he was like that. And he taught us that in Odisha Dance Academy, even the young boy or girl, he introduced male dancers into the Odissi field as performer. Most of the male dancers, when they learn Odissi or any art form, they become teachers. Over the years, they start teaching at it. Because he's the one, since he came from Gotipur background, he said there are so many male dancers in our school, and Odisha Dance Academy can proudly, humbly say that we have produced the largest number of male dancers in Odissi as an art form. So all the male dancer, he created a male dancer ensemble and he started teaching them, keeping their personality and their mannerism, their, you know, understanding of dance in mind. But he taught us that, suppose I am a student in Odisha Dance Academy. He said, as a part of your syllabus, part of your training process, you have to teach younger groups, younger classes. So that is kind of our placement there. So we will experience that whatever we are learning, how we are applying that knowledge into teaching. And the end of the year, every teacher who is assigned to a particular class, they have to choreograph a small, maybe it's a folk dance or Odissi or just a dance piece based on the music. You have to choreograph with the same batch of students. So over the years, in 10 years, all our dance performers, they have good experience in teaching, and also subsequently, they develop that ability to become composer and choreographer. That is the Guru Sisya Parampara he introduced. Today, we have 500 students in our school. We have almost 37 to 40 teachers who are performer. So we have 3 repertory units, but all of us are, we are still realizing Guru's dream, and we are all staying together because he once told me that you can dig up small, small wells. You can get fragmented and dig up small, small wells. But if you stay together, you can create a lake or a big pond. So all of us, last 50 years, I have been associated with Guruji's institution. And when he passed away, as a senior member, I'm a little emotional when I'm talking about him. I'm kind of leading the group, but all of us are students there. Even today, all of us are students there. All of us are teachers there. All of us are performer there. And today also, when I am kind of, you know, the senior most student in Odisha Dance Academy, I think I have to learn so much. So we are kind of taking this Guru Shishya Parampara forward, but we are very much attached to our roots. And we remember all the gurus. My guru has learned from them. So they are our kind of, the prabaha, the flow of dance form. We are kind of keeping that in mind. We are creating. We are experimenting. We are branching out. But we try to always understand and be within the territory of the parampara. That is how we understand the Guru Sisya Parampara and the relationship. And it is such a beautiful thing that without the Guru, Sisya is incomplete. It's like two sides of the coin. Today I am a Shishya. Tomorrow I am a teacher. And when I become a teacher, I remember that how I learned from my guru and how I can pass on that quality, learning, wisdom, knowledge to the next generation. So always our gurus are Namashya.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Over to Bhumika.
नमस्कारम श्रीमती अरुणा मोहंती जी. मैम, जैसे एक कलाकार को सफलता प्राप्त करने के लिए मेहनत के साथ साथ कई तरह के संघर्षों का भी सामना करना पड़ता है, तो क्या आप गुरुजी के जीवन से जुड़े कुछ ऐसे वाक्य बताएंगी जिससे आज की पीढ़ी के कलाकारों को सफलता मिले?
सफलता, यू नो द सक्सेस, इट्स अ रिलेटिव टर्म, राइट? For you, probably, you know, dancing in a very prestigious festival is success. For me, probably, you know, if I'm dancing in Bhubaneswar, but in front of the Rasikas who appreciate and encourage me to, you know, to grow in my life, probably that is success. So what Guruji, Guru Gangadhar Padhan, who came from a very remote village, who worked very hard. He didn't have enough money. He had very, you know, limited resources. He used to tell us that he used to starve himself to, you know, save money to buy mardala, the instrument, the drum. And he used to ride bicycles, go from, you know, students, one student to another student home to teach. So those are the time he's really struggled, but he never settled for quantity. He always said quality. I remember when the students come from outside, from foreign countries, they want to learn something in 3 days, 4 days, say, "Ki, we will learn one item and we will go away." Guruji used to, and they used to promise a lot of money to Guruji, but Guruji always smile and tell them, "Beta, you will learn in 3-4 days. So obviously you will not be able to perfect the technique and the, you know, the beautiful nuances of Odissi. When you go back, I'll get the money. But when you go back and teach there or perform there, you will only pass on the half-baked knowledge. So you will create bad Odissi there. So I might as well take less money from you, teach you for a longer time. And when I'm satisfied about the perfection, I'll ask you to go ahead. That I choose over 3-4 days. Maine sikha liya, then you go away. Whatever do you do with that, I don't care. He never had that kind of attitude. So in Odisha Dance Academy, even today, after 10 years, we evaluate whether the students have that kind of passion to take up Odissi as profession, in spite of knowing this is a path of struggle, because this has no kind of certainty about, you know, the money, the how much money you are going to earn. Suppose this month I get 3 programs, probably another month I won't get one, even one program. But with my passion, with my love for dance, because when I dance, the kind of happiness I get, probably the money cannot buy it. But money is needed to do good work. Money is needed to support my students. Money is needed to create platforms and opportunity for people and the artists to come together. So first you have to love the art form, and you have to be happy with it by doing that. And then these hurdles and the, you know, difficulties to, you know, keep up with the challenge will be, you know, bearable. I will say bearable. But wherever you do not work hard, you very well should know that the success will remain far away.
Dhanyavad, ma'am. Over to Mahvika.
Namaskaram, Aruna Mohanty ji. मैम, आप गुरुजी के बहुत से कार्यक्रमों के दौरान उनके साथ रहे होंगे, क्या आपको कोई ऐसा वाक्य याद है जो आपके लिए हर्षमय हो या आपको उससे कोई प्रेरणा मिली हो?
थैंक यू मेविका. first of all, you know, dance is not always taught in the classroom. Dance is a process like your life. You learn it in every step. I will tell you something which all of you probably find it very humorous. Guruji used to say that you should live, sleep, breathe to dance. Once we were traveling somewhere, we were in the airport. Suddenly we saw Guruji is holding a kind of a pillar and doing some kind of, you know, body movement. We were also, oh my God, people will think that this gentleman is crazy or he has gone mad. So we said, ki Guruji, aisa mat kijiyega na. What people are thinking. He said, kyun bhai? I was kind of sitting in the flight for 21 hours. So I need my body to be more flexible. And, you know, I want my dance to keep my body alive. So I'm doing it. So what you should do when you learn chauka or trivanga, when you are brushing your teeth also in the bathroom, sit in chauka position and brush. Din, dinna, dinita. Like that. And if someone has come to your house and you want to give him or her a glass of water, you should come like that. Your life should be like a poetry where you use the experience of your dance. Then you know what? Without thinking also, that poem will transform into a beautiful, you know, visual motifs through your dance. So you used to think like that. Another thing you used to do, which I used to hate, that whenever there is a music composition or you need a text for a composition, you go to the Sanskrit scholar, you go to the Odia scholar and get the poem, interpret it, write the meaning and explanation, everything. I used to say, he's going to do the composition. Why should I go to so many people and collect all this information? He can very well do it. But you say, no, I am not that educated. But that doesn't mean that you people will not go and find, you know, the text and interpretation of it. So you should go. Okay, we go and get all those texts and verses and everything. And then he'll say, sit when I'm doing the music composition. I used to think, why am I going to sit there? Just, you know, listen to you explaining to the musician and music getting composed. So what am I learning from it? But then he'll say, no, you have to be there. And when the music composition is done, then he will do the dance on me, the choreography and the composition. And he'll say, you teach this to these dancers, group of dancers, that group of dancer or him or her. I said, Guruji could have done that directly with them. Why a bhaiya media like me? But when I started working and when Guruji was not there, those frames were coming to my mind as if they are the milestones. Like a film, it was running in my mind, frame after frame, that what I learned being with the scholar, what I learned being with the musician, how Guruji's idea got translated into music, how he used to explain it to the musician, the taal, what taal will be, you know, appropriate for what character, all that. When I became a choreographer and composer, it came so naturally to me. I owe it to him completely. That is what is parampara. That is what is Girishishya parampara. And these are some of the moments which is keeping him alive in our mind. All of our students, all 50 composers in Odisha Dance Academy, you ask them, they will think in a similar way with little bit of variations because we are thinking in a particular way, the way Guruji has shown us the path. So it was not a master that who has composed so many items or who has done so many workshops. He was not like that. But he has planted the seed in different villages, in different districts, and has tried to bring that to the every doorstep. He said, if the people of Odisha will not claim that this is my dance, this is my music, rest of India, how will they appreciate?
Thank you, ma'am. Over to you, Tamanna.
नमस्कार मैम मैम मैं आपसे ये जानना चाहती हूँ कि गुरु गंगाधर प्रधान जी ने अपनी पहली शिक्षा कहाँ से प्राप्त की और उनके फैमिली मेंबर्स ने उनका उनका कितना सपोर्ट किया और उनकी कितनी कोऑपरेशन रही है
Guruji came from a village called Parikul in Brahmagiri district. That district was famous for music and the Gotipur dance and, you know, the Odissi music and the Rasa tradition, which is a kind of a Vaishnavite traditions of dance and music. So he came from that village, like, you know, in his introduction, you heard that he fell down and he had a kind of a injury there. And then his parents, they kind of given him to the temple that Bhagwan isko bachalo so that he will dance for you. So that's how he became a Gotipur dancer. And Gotipur dance, you will probably get to see in the video, it is a very, very tough training process because you have to do acrobatic things. And, you know, it is very complicated body challenges there. So they used to dance in the morning and even after lunch, in the evening, till, you know, the last dhupa, you know, the aalti of the god and goddesses in the temple. So when he was a Gotipur dancer, he learned how to play mardala and sing also, because that was a characteristics of Gotipur dancer. So he was trained like that. And after 13th or 14 years old, you can't practice Gotipur. So the next option was either he will sit in the village, open a pawn shop or, you know, something there in the village or farming, or he'll come to Odissi. So he chose to come to Odissi. He came to Bhubaneswar and joined Utkal Sangeet Mahavidyala, that is the college for dance and music. So he joined there. He got the, you know, opportunity and blessings of Guruji, like Adi Gurus, Guru Pankacharan Das, Guru Deva Prashad Das, Mardala Guru, Guru Banamali Maharana, Dr. Minati Mishra. And then he got a national scholarship and learned under Padma Vibhushan, Guru Kalicharan Mahapat. So like when you eat khichdi, you know, it is very nutritious because it has got vegetables, dal and rice, carbohydrate, protein and fiber, everything in it. Similarly, Guruji, Guru Gangadhar Pradhanji, got the knowledge from Gotipur. And then when he started Odissi, he learned from Devasar, Pankasar, Kelusar, and Guru Banamali Marana, Mardala, and all that. So it is, his learning process got enriched. So he understood the nuances of Odissi, and the perfection for him was the trademark. You will not believe the same item of 12 minutes he'll make us do in a very slow tempo. Like I'll just give you one example. Tari, tita, dhi, dhalla, ang, ta, 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 ta. Suppose this is a small dance piece. He'll make us do this one small piece 10 times. Then he'll just increase the pace. Tari, kitta, di, dhalla, anga, ta, ta. He'll say, practice this 20 times. Then he'll increase the pace. Tari, kitta, di, dhalla, anga, ta, ta. He said, practice this 30 times. Why he made us do that? Because he thought that the perfection you have when you are walking slow and with the increase of pace, the perfection and the percentage of the movement, how it should decrease also and appropriately used. So he was very scientific in his approach to understand dance. Like in Odissi, you all know it is very semicircular. He used to put a paper on the wall and put, you know, the dots. He said, with your hand, touch all that dirt and then make a line, you'll get a perfect semicircle. So with that, and he wanted us to know our body, the alignment, when we are sitting in Trivanga and Chauka, how you are moving your spine and how you're distributing the weights of the body. And when you're standing in one foot, when using both the sport, when you are jumping. He used to explain us without the formal education. He went into it with so much of interest and, you know, the quest for knowledge. He used to explain to us scientifically and how upper part of the body should be still when you are moving your feet. And believe me, today, whenever I teach or I see my students teaching their students, I could see that thinking process, how it has filtered down. So it is a beautiful process. It is a beautiful understanding and it's a beautiful soul. So what we are keeping as legacy is this soul.
Thank you, ma'am. Over to Gaurika Didi.
Thank you, Tamanna. Namaskaram, ma'am. मैम, हम आपसे गुरु गंगाधर प्रधान जी के बारे में कुछ और बातें जानना चाहेंगे, जैसे उनका कैसा स्वभाव था, वे कैसे थे, तो अगर आप बता सकें।
गौरिका, if I tell you how he used to be tough with us, you will think that he is a what call devil reincarnated. He used to be so strict with us. He used to hit us, slap us, and you know whatever. The stick, wooden stick, he will be giving tal to, he'll throw at us and things like that. Then it was okay, but now we can't do it because things have changed. But he used to hit us and he used to give us long pravachans that what one should do and should not do, how you should wear your clothes and how you should greet people, how you should do pranam and how you should eat and everything. But when he is in the class, I remember once my mother came into the room and saw me crying. So he very politely, she very politely asked Guruji, "Ki itna maro mat, you know, poor girl, she loves dance, but she's now scared of you." Because when he used to come home to teach me, I used to tell my grandmother, because my mother will never listen to me. My grandmother, I used to tell her, I said, "Batao, Guruji ko batao ki mujhe bukhar hai, main kar nahi sakti," you know. So I used to hide behind my grandmother, ki mera tabiyat thik nahi hai, I won't be able to do it. Guruji will come and stand there. My grandmother will say, "Gonga, in Odia, Gonga, ta deho kharap achi, she's not well." Guruji will look at me. "Cha, dekh raha tujhe." Then he'll hold my hand. He'll just pull me from wherever I'll be hiding. And he'll say, "Acha, kya hua hai? Batao." I said, "Bukhar hai. Thermometer lao." So then he'll check himself. Say, "Nahi, bukhar nahi hai. Aur kya hai?" Then he'll say, "Acha, mujhe kuch nahi sunna hai. You have to practice. If you don't practice, you won't eat today. No dinner for you. So practice." And then I'll practice. And then if he'll, you know, hit me with whatever stick and things like that, I'll be crying. He said, "Acha, you cry. Doesn't matter. But there should be a smile on your face." So I used to dance like this. Dari jham, dari jham. It's like, smile. Do whatever expression you are doing. But cry. I don't care whether, you know, the tears are coming down or not. But you have to smile. So that kind of thing he used to do. And he never used to give us a kind of a, "Acha, aaj, theek hai, rehne do. Aaj ye nahi karte hain, theek hai." You'll never say that. You have to do exercise stepping for 1 hour. Then you have to do chari, bhramari, and little bit of theory. Then you have to do one mangalacharan, one pallavi, one abhinaya, and moksha every day in the class. 4 hours class, no release. But today, at the age of 60, 62, the kind of footwork I can do, the stamina I have, I owe it to him. Not only me, all our students, we owed it to him. If you would not have been that strict with us while kind of, you know, in our classes and in our training process, then we would have been lazy. You know, when you are lazy, your mind stop thinking. So, and then it won't be so productive. तो दैट्स व्हाट ही वाज बट ही वाज अ मर्सीलेस परफेक्शनिस्ट फॉर एवरी सिंगल थिंग इफ आई एम यू नो गोइंग फॉर द परफॉर्मेंस एंड माय हेयर इज हियर वन स्ट्रैंड इज हियर और धागा ब्लैक धागा फ्रॉम द फ्लावर इट हैज कम आउट or my blouse is slightly loose here, or my ghungru ka dhaga has come out, something like that. Small Smriti used to get furious about it. That half an hour before you have to finish everything and you have to look at like, you know, each other and see ki everything is perfect. And on stage, if one jewelry of yours will fall down, just to get furious. Everything has to be perfect. That sense of perfection has put Orissa Dance Academy as one of the leading institution. And when you used to organize festivals, starting from where the lamp should be, where the Jagannath statue should be, where the you know the guests will come and they have to take off their shoes and chappals or sandals, where it should happen, where they will stand, where the camera team will be, and the flowers and entry and exit and starting on time and ending, finishing. He was really tough with all this. He used to make us do all this before, one day before the festival begins. And he'll, you know, today the festival is finished. For the second day, he'll do the rehearsal with all the backstage people. So that is the kind of commitment he had.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for answering all the questions so beautifully. We are finished with the interactive session. And now it is a request to all of you to watch calmly and quietly, see the great master perform now. Over to technical team.
Before we start the presentation, the video presentation, we have divided it into two parts. First part is his teaching. He's teaching his regular classes. And then, of course, as Aruna Mohantiji has been saying, that he himself was a Gotipua dancer. And he established a Gotipua school called Konark Natya Mandap. And how he did it, it's a small documentary made by Discovery Channel. And then in the second part, there are two of his performances. One is with the group, a group performance. And the last one is a solo one. So before we start, I'll just ask very briefly if Aruna ji can tell us about the Gotipua. And also, since you asked about Guruji, his nature, I'll just add on one thing. We had called him to do a Gotipua group tour for the entire Rajasthan. And he was accompanying all those young children, young boys. And when he came to Kota, he was here for 3 days. When he left, after that, I was told that the group was headed by Guru Gangadhar Pradhan. And when I came to know much later about his, his stature as a guru, I felt so ashamed because he was just not demanding. He was so simple. He was one of the simplest person I have come across in my life. You know what? The position which he was on, you know, he could have, but he was staying with the students. And he was staying wherever we had kept everybody else. So he was a very, very down-to-earth, a very soft-spoken person. And so before we show, I'll just...
Can I just add one, two lines to what you said?
Yeah, of course.
He was so simple in his approach. He was so simple with his lifestyle. Even till he passed away, he was sleeping in a big hall with 20 male dancers on chatai. He never asked for any special treatment, any special attention, or any special food, or nothing like that. He never treated any of his fellow musicians also differently. He was really a kind of a bright example of, you know, the samabhava.
Absolutely.
He was very simple. He has never created any property or anything for his family or for his benefit or his kind of materialistic position. Everything he has created for art and artist.
Yeah, very true. So, Rajik, can you just tell the children a bit about the Gotipua, what Gotipua means actually? and then we can show these two films.
Children, it is very interesting. You will see the video now. The goti was actually the male child when they were very young, like 5 years, starting from 5 years, when their other parents offer them to the temple, they are initiated into learning the dance form. This dance form is very closely associated with Odissi because it is a little cruder form of what you see the Sanskritized or polished form, which is Odissi. The same Trivanga, same grammar, and use of the same songs, Vaishnavite songs. Actually, you know, in Puri, you know about Jagannath Temple. In Jagannath Temple, there are different festivals. In 12 months, there are 13 festivals. In summer, in winter, in rainy season, in autumn, in spring, there are very many seasons. So during these festivals, when they go in a procession, these Gotipo dancers, they perform in front of this procession. So these Gotipo dancers are dressed like female dancers. They put all the chittas here, they tie their hair, they make a bun, and the flowers, and the jewelry, kanchula, and the sari, and dupatta, everything. So they, you will not make out whether they are female or male dancers. They look like female dancers. And they sing and they dance. And sometimes there are two, three things they do. They sing in praise of gods and goddesses. And then they dance like Pallavis. Thei thei inda kata kata ham ta ata ta. Your dance based on music. And that's called bandha, where they do gymnastics. And when they are trained, they, which is must, make their bodies supple, all the joints. So in the morning and in the evening, there are people who they will be sleeping on the floor and people will massage oil onto them. And then different kind of exercises, all asanas in yoga, they do it with perfection. And very difficult and complicated asanas also. And they, as they grow, they learn to sing and also play music. And when they are 13 or 14 years, when they attend their adolescent period, then they stop dancing because by then, you know, they will develop the mustache and the beard and things like that. They lose that charm, the innocent charm of the young boys. Then they move to Odissi. So Gotipo dance was very much associated with the temple traditions in Odisha. And you know why the Gotipos came? Because there were Devadasis, the female dancers in the temples. But when the Britishers came and before that, the Mughals came and the foreign invasion happened. And you know, the girls were stopped to come out and perform for the gods and goddesses and for the people that they never used to do it. So to replace that, these young boys were dressed like girls and they were initiated into performances related to relating to all the festivals associated with the temples, like Jhulona Jatra, with Ratha Yatra, the big car festivals of Lord Jagannath. So it is very much a Vaishnavite traditions dance form where they sing in praise of Lord Krishna mostly, but Vishnu and Jagannath.
Thank you so much, Agnaji. Abhishek, can we start the videos?
Before the video, I will request everyone to please switch off your cameras and also your mics. And also, so as already told by Ashokji, the video is in two parts. So we are playing with the first part now.